Hi, I am Dr. Leela Mohan, PVR. I had done my MBBS MD. I am general medicine physician. I practice at Motherhood and Rainbow Hospital, Sajapur Road. I have my own center called as Padithem Healthcare. That is in HSR layout, Bangalore. Yes, fasting definitely we recommend. 12 hours fasting, it should be 100% recommended in getting tested the lipid profile. Always the food will interfere in increasing the triglyceride levels. When the fasting is done properly, it won't interact anything with the triglyceride, so that we'll get the accurate levels for measuring. So the fasting will definitely affect the importance or the test levels. It will not alter your cholesterol levels. Other than water in between these 12 hours, nothing should be consumed. So we should get it done, the testing very frequently. The adults, it can be around the age of 20 years, 4 to 5 years, once at least they have to get it done in a low risk individuals. And then high risk individuals is nothing but if the age is crossing more than 30 or 40 years, or people who are having habits like smoking and drinking, or lack of sleep, any stress, these people who should get it done at least yearly once or 2 years once. If once you are diagnosed with the levels like cholesterol levels, it has to be checked at least 6 months once, which will be very useful for treating the cholesterol levels. Those who are having a family history of heart disease or stroke, they often use it to get the tests done. That is like 3 months once or 6 months once. Along with the cholesterol levels, they can usually get it done ECG, that is electrocardiogram, and 2D echo, or the certain tests. And there is a test called as TMT, that is threadmill test, which will definitely help in preventing the strokes and paralysis or cardiovascular diseases due to cholesterol. So the normal total cholesterol level should be less than 200. If it is 200 to 300, we'll call it as borderline. If above 300 levels, it is highly risky. So the LDL levels should be less than 100. That is very optimal and it is considered as normal. If the levels are again in between 200 to 129, we'll call it as borderline. 129 to above 150, 160, we'll call it as risky. And then above or beyond that, definitely the healthcare profession has to be intervened to control these levels.